Hey, it's Ryan with Parts Doctor, and today I'm going to show you how to test the voltage to the evaporator fan motor on the Samsung refrigerator. We'll need a few different tools for the job. We'll leave those listed in the description below. Let's get started. The first thing that we'll need to do is remove the door bins, shelves, and drawers from the refrigerator. With those removed from the refrigerator, we can now remove the vegetable drawer cover. Depress the two locking clips on the side of the filter case assembly, then lift up on the vegetable drawer cover and pull it out to remove it. Using a flat blade screwdriver, pry out the top screw cover. Now remove these four Phillips screws. With the screws removed, you can now remove the center shelf support. With all of the screws removed, you can now remove the evaporator cover. If the cover is stuck in place, you'll want to unplug the refrigerator and leave the doors open to let it thaw out before you remove the cover. Locate the locking tabs indicated by the arrows, then pull on the evaporator cover around the locking tabs, then pull down and pivot to the left to remove it. You'll want to be careful as there will still be some wires connected in the upper left-hand corner. With the cover opened up, we'll now use these two magnets to bypass the door switches to trick the refrigerator into thinking that the doors are closed. The evaporator fan motors will only run if the refrigerator is shut, so if you have a bad door switch, it can cause the fan motor to not run. There's also a delay of 10 to 60 seconds from when you close the doors before the fan motors will turn on. Now we'll tape the two small magnets to the top of the front cover. The location of the switches is indicated by these two arrows. With the magnets in the correct locations, the interior light should turn off. Once that's done, you can use a multimeter to test the power to the fan motor. If you have an auto-ranging multimeter, turn your meter to the DC voltage setting. If you have a manual-ranging multimeter, turn your meter to the lowest setting of 20 or 40. There are three wires that go to the fan motor. The red and black wires are the power wires. The white wire relays the fan speed back to the control board. Insert the black probe from the meter into the end of the plug with the black wire, and insert the red probe into the end of the plug with the red wire. The fan motor operates at two different speeds. On high, the fan motor is giving us approximately 11.3 volts DC. On the low speed, we're getting approximately 8.3 volts DC. If you're getting proper voltage to the fan motor, but the fan motor isn't running, you most likely have a bad fan motor. If you're not getting proper power to the fan motor, then you may have a bad main control board. If the fan speed is sensed too high or too low by the main control board, the fan circuit will be disabled. After 10 seconds, the main control board will try again by sending power for 3 seconds. If it's unable to start, it will try again 5 more times before disabling the fan circuit for 10 minutes. The fan speed can be too low if the refrigerator is not properly going through the automatic defrost cycle. If the evaporator coil is frosted up, it will slow down the airflow, causing the fan motor to not run fast enough. If you find that you have a bad part and you need to purchase a new one, you can check out our website, partsdoctor.com. We'll leave a link in the description below. You want to make sure that you search with the model number from the tag on your refrigerator to make sure that you get the correct part. To reassemble the refrigerator, we'll start by removing the magnets. To reinstall the evaporator cover, turn the cover, insert the top, and push the locking clips until they snap into place. Next, insert the center shelf support, then reinstall the four Phillips screws. Next, reinstall the screw cap. Next, reinstall the vegetable drawer cover by setting it on the side rails, pushing it back, and then lifting up on the filter case to lock it in place. Next, you can reinstall the drawers, shelves, and door bins. So that's it for this video. If you have any tips or tricks of your own, let us know in the comments below.